Very good morning, my dear student. So in the last class we discussed about articles in grammar. In this class we are going to discuss about the first chapter of English, that is A Hero. This A Hero is written by R.K. Narayan. Do you know who is R.K. Narayan? Yes, R.K. Narayan is widely considered to be one of the greatest Indian English novelist. He is very famous. His novels include Swami and His Friends, The English Teacher, The Bachelor of Arts, and The Financial Expert. The Guide is another important novel of R.K. Narayan. It is very important because this novel is adapted for the film, and this The Guide is won the award Sahitya Academy Award. So most of the people like to read R.K. Narayan's novels because he uses simple and unpretentious writing style so that a common people can understand his language. Unpretentious means a simple language. So in his novels, his contents are social related. Content oriented is social events, so that many people can easily understand his novels. So my dear student, let us start the lesson A Hero. This lesson is about a boy, a brave boy. Let us see who is the brave boy in this lesson. Very curious. This lesson is very curious and very interesting. So at the end of the lesson, we come to know that who is the brave boy. So let us see first. For Swami, events took an unexpected turn. Father looked over the newspaper he was reading under the hall lamp and said, in the beginning of the lesson, so this is the lesson about Swami. In the beginning of the lesson, Swami was sitting and his father was reading the newspaper. For Swami, some events are unexpected. So in our life, in someone's life, we can guess what is happening, but for Swami, in his life, events took an unexpected turn in his life. So, father looked over the newspaper he was reading under the hall lamp and said, where was Swami's father reading the newspaper? Swami's father was reading the newspaper under the hall lamp. Keep it in your mind, my dear friends. So Swami's father was reading the newspaper under the hall lamp. Okay, now next. Swami, listen to this. News has been received about the bravery of a village lad who, while returning home by the jungle path, came face to face with a tiger. Swami's father was reading the newspaper. In that newspaper, a paragraph was described about a brave boy, a bravery village boy. Who is that? What is that matter? Let's see. So, Swami's father was reading the newspaper. In the newspaper, so news has been received about the bravery of a village lad. The bravery of a village lad who, while returning home by the jungle path. So that boy, that village lad, was returning by the jungle path. So when he was returning from the home, so he came face to face with a tiger. A tiger came in front of the village boy. So it is very scared about that village boy who is scared, and what he did, let's see. So So that village boy was very scared about the tiger. Many people also are scared about the tiger, right? So this boy is also scared about the tiger. The paragraph describes the fight the boy had with the tiger and his flight of the tree where he stayed off it till some people came that way and killed the tiger. So what was the paragraph described? That paragraph was described the fight the boy had with the tiger and his flight up the tree where he stayed off a day till some people came that way and killed the tiger. That brave boy, that village lad. So when the tiger came face to face, so what he did? He just flight up the tree and he stayed off a day till the people, till the people came that way. So this shows the braveness of that village boy. Understand? So we told you that, I told you that that boy, the village boy, was a brave because, for example, if we came face to face with a tiger, what we did? What we are going to do? So we just scared about the tiger and just fell down. But that boy is not scared about the tiger. He did a plan and just flight up the tree and he stayed there. Next, after reading it through, Father looked at Swami fixedly, asked. So after reading that paragraph, Swami's father fixedly looked towards Swami. Why he is looking towards his son? Why? Because Swami was very scared about the knife, particularly about the knives. So you people also scared about the knives. So that you are also like Swami. So now Swami's father, after reading that paragraph, he looked towards Swami and he asked something. What he asked? Let's see. You think you are wiser than the newspaper? So Swami's father was questioning to Swami that you think you are wiser than the newspaper? Wiser than the newspaper means you are wiser than the village lad. You are braver than the village lad who was questioning. So students, keep it in your mind. In the examination, the question will be asked like this. Do you people heard about extract? Okay, na? So this line is very, very important for extract. So the question will be asked like this. Like this. You think you are wiser than the newspaper. Who said this? Who said this? Swami's father was said. To whom this was said to? This was said to his son. Swami's father said these words to Swami. When he said like this, so when father, Swami's father, read the newspaper, the newspaper was described about a village boy, so the bravery of the village boy, then only Swami's father asked like this to Swami. So keep it in your mind, dear friend. So in this lesson, you can learn so many things. And next, a frightful proposition, Swami thought. He had always slept beside his granny in the passage, and any changes in this arrangement kept him trembling and wake all the night. So where was Swami usually slept? Swami usually slept beside his granny. So this one shows And after he asked the question, "You think you are wiser than the newspaper?" When Gothar asked like this to Swami, he was very scared. And then, the Swami's character is, he was always scared about the nights, particularly nights, and where he always sleep, always. Swami always slept beside his grand. If any changes in this matter, so, he was trembling, he was scared and weak all the night. That makes, if any changes in his sleeping, so that makes him awake all the night. This is the thing. So Swami was always scared about the night. So next, he hoped at first that father was only joking. He mumbled weakly. So in the beginning, what Swami thought? Swami's father was just joking, but he is not joking. He was seriously, he was telling to Swami, and he mumbled weakly. He himself telling that my father is joking now. So, but that is not a joke. That is a serious thought of Swami's father. Swami was, now he was thinking that his father was just joking, but his father was very serious about to check the braveness of his son. Next, for changing his mind, Swami, what he did for changing his father's mind, he was talking about something, he was talking about different. So what was that? We are going to admit even elders in our cricket club. Hereafter, we are buying brand new bats and balls. Our captain has asked me to tell you. He is just changing his father's mind. So that he was asking about something. He was telling about something. What is that? So, we are going to admit the even elders in our cricket team. He was telling about his cricket team. So in the cricket team, we are going to admit the elders, even elders can play in our team, and we are buying brand new bats and balls. I want bats and balls, a brand new balls and bats. This is just for changing his mind, changing his father's mind. But Swami's father, he was stick on to checking his son's braveness. We will see about that later. Swami's father, he told, so we will see about that later. Who said these words? This sentence is said by Swami's father. To whom? To Swami. Next. From the first of next month, I will sleep alone, father. So, in the beginning, what father was told to Swami? So, you have to sleep in alone. So that Swami was just trying to change his mind, change his father's mind. But it did not work. It is not works. So that he was telling, Swami was telling, he was convincing. He was convincing to his father what he did. So from the first of next month, I will sleep. So in the next month, I will sleep alone. So now, just let me go. So in the next month, I will sleep. But today, you just let me go. He was convincing. Next, I hardly know anything about the war. So, Swami's mother was supporting to his son. Okay, now his mother and his grandmother was supporting to his son. father is not like that. He wants his son to be brave. Okay, na? So that he told him to sleep alone. But Swami and his mother did not agree. Swami's father sat gloomily gazing at the newspaper on his lap. Swami rose silently and tiptoed to his bed in the passage. Swami's father was sat gloomily gazing at the newspaper. Swami's father was just acting. He was just gazing at the newspaper. He was just looking at the newspaper and watched his son where he was going to sleep. But what Swami did? Swami rose silently. Swami was silently. He get up and tiptoed to his bed in the passage. He just silently get up and go towards the bed. His bed, his own bed. He was scared about the nights, particularly nights. Granny was sitting up in her bed and remarked. When Swami entering into the bed, entering into his room, so his grandmother was sitting and she was just telling something. So Swami threw himself on his bed and pulled the blanket over his face. So when he entering into the Swami's room, so in that room, Granny was sitting. She was trying to tell something, but Swami was he just pulled the blanket over his face and slept. Shut up, Granny. Don't talk to me and don't let anyone call me. Even if the house is on fire, if I don't sleep at once, perhaps I shall die. So this much of scare he has, so that he. So here his grandmother was trying to talk something and she wants to share something to his grandson, but Swami was not ready to listen her words. What he told to his granny, please shut up granny, so escaped from my father and I'm trying to sleep here, so that don't disturb me. Please granny, you just shut up and so I want to sleep. Don't talk to me and don't let anyone call me if the house is on fire. So, what a joke. What Swami was telling, if the house is on fire, so don't make me to wake up. So, he was requesting to his grandmother. So, if he wakes up, his father makes him to sleep alone. So that he is telling like this. Next, presently his father came and stood over him. So on the next, Swami's father came to his room and stood in front of Swami. Stood in front of the Swami. Why do you disturb him? So she was telling that why you are disturbing to your son. So he was already slept. Why you are disturbing? His grandmother was telling like this. And then, so father was said that, so make him wake up. And father for the third time, and Swami got up. So he called at last, in the third time, Swami's father called him and Swami got up. Thank you. We will continue in the next.